We get scared to push away those stones that keep us trapped, or we don't want to seize the effort it will take to remove the obstacles between us and God. We're afraid to walk out and let God and others see us as we are. And this is the good news, friends, though. The air outside is sweet. The life we can have in God's presence as we are is full of hope and new promise and possibility. That's why every messenger sent from God, like the angel early in the morning, the angels that herald Jesus' birth, all of them, the first thing they say, don't be afraid. Or the old King James, I love that, fear not. God wants nothing but good for each of us. God wants you to experience the life on the other side of that oppressive stone. So why don't we trust? Why do we let the grip of our fear pull us deeper into that dark cave? Why do we keep crying, I can't roll the stone away? Why do we not rely on God's strength and courage? Why don't we listen to the still speaking God calling us to new life? I think it's because we have this voice inside of us. Oh, we all have it. I hear it. I hear it inside myself. It's self-generated, world-produced. You can't find new life, we say to ourselves. You've been dead too long. Don't think you can change now. That old message just repeats itself. But there are parts of us that need to be raised up by the power and love of God, like the child succumbing to neglect, the joy that succumbs to anxiety and worry, the real us that we push aside for a facade. Many are the names of the dead spots within us. Many are the risings that need and can take place. Jesus stands outside the tombs of our souls, calls our name. He ignores that inner voice of protest, and he said, yes, you can bring life back to that. Who will roll away the stone? With God's help, we will. That's why God is God and we're not. Because when we think we can't, God can. God gives us the strength to push out of the darkness, to walk into the light, to breathe in the air of acceptance and forgiveness, wholeness. God is calling you. Are you listening? So we're going to have a little interactive time together. On the count of three, I want you to say your name. I'm serious about this. So on the count of three, let's all say our name. One, two, three, Sara. You. You that just called. God cries to each of you. Push aside those things that hold you in living death and embrace the new life I give you. How does that song that we sing say it? I am the word that leads all to freedom. I am the peace the world cannot give. I call you by name, embrace your pain, stand up and walk and live. Easter is about knowing that whatever earthly darkness threatens us, whatever waves of grief that wash over us, whatever tombs we feel buried in, God still is calling us because God wants nothing but life for us. So Jesus our Christ shows us that promise. That is our hope. So what difference does Easter make? It makes all the difference in the world. Thanks be to God.